Hey, come and get ready with me and I'll share some of my fun summertime products.
Grab a cup of coffee or something sweet to drink and come on. And you know, I just want to say this. Yes, I am into my 60s and I still love makeup. I still love to do my face. I still love and get excited over the new stuff that's out there. I've just realized that at this point in my life, I'm very cautious about taking care of my skin. And it's so nice that I can now put together my makeup and use a lot less and not have to cover so much up. First thing I did this morning was wash my face with Rodan and Fields. I let my face dry and set for a little bit, and then I went ahead and used this. This is the Hourglass Veil Primer. I've been using this for quite a while. What this does is really allows my foundation and or powder to just go on so smoothly, and it just evens out, I think, my skin tone. So, love this. And I do things a little bit differently. Next, I'm going to go ahead and apply the Rodan and Fields Mineral Peptide Powder. Now, the reason I'm applying this as my very next step, even before I put on any kind of concealer or undercover, if I have any blemishes that are really dark and sticking out, I'll go ahead and use the MAC concealer. And what I'll do is I'll just cover that up just a bit. And I see a little cover-up spot there. So, the mineral peptide powders are very good for you because those peptides onto your skin, really, this mineral peptide powder also that has an SPF of 20, really helps cut any of the redness that you may have going on your skin. I'm going to apply it with this Heavenly It cosmetic brush. It picks the product up really well from the lid, and what I do is I start at the center of my forehead and I just tap it right down center of my nose and around my T-zone area and my chin, and I just use a really light tapping motion. I'm just applying a small amount of it, and then I just kind of tap it up over my forehead and spread it out a little. I just want those peptides, and I want that little bit of SPF protection. And as you can hear, I'm shaking up my favorite. This is the Clinique. It is the Acne Solution BB Cream. It's very light. It's, as you can see, it's pretty liquidy. I put about 4 little drops on there. But today I'm just gonna go ahead and put it on with my fingers and cover my forehead area and just tap it in. I swoop up what I had left on my hand, and honestly, believe it or not, this is an e.l.f. flat top brush, and it works really well with this BB cream. It's very light, and it does make my skin very matte. I have excessively oily skin, and especially living here with all this high humidity. Next, I'm gonna go in with, now, my Color Correcting by Guerlain. Light Warm 01, little tiny bit, and I'm gonna show you. It goes a long way. That's it. And I basically use this as that color correcting because I do have issues with dark circles under my eyes, allergy season, and I take really good care of that under eye skin area. This area is so tender, that skin, and it just, you know, everything else just kind of settles into those fine lines. But I like to put this on after I put on either a BB cream or if I'm wearing a foundation. I like this to be right on top. And this has a very matte type finish. It's not oily, greasy, and anything that's left over, even a little bit, I just kind of tap on top of my lids there. And I used the Anastasia Brow Wiz pencil. I've had my eyebrows microbladed. I've talked about that before, but I just go ahead and have to just draw a little subtle line here and do a little bit on the extension. And let me tell you, this process, I literally spend 2 to 3 minutes drawing those little bits in, where I was spending anywhere from, on a good day, 30 minutes to 40, 45 minutes drawing my brows in, because my brows were so sparse. And I just can't even tell you how happy I am. This is a really good eyelash curler. I spent some bucks on it. I'm very well worth the money. And I'm gonna try to come in so you can see. My eyelashes from using the product Lash Boost do curl on their own. I have nothing on them. But I like to go ahead. The curl tends to crimp and hold. And since I've been using the Lash Boost, my lashes are much more fortified. They're much more natural looking. They accept mascara so well. And with this curler, I hardly ever have had any issue at all with pinching my skin. And that's about the way my eyelashes look at this point. Then I do this because, guys, I love this MAC Prep and Prime. And I know it says prep, so of course that means I should be doing it in advance, but I do it on top because let's talk about my age. I mean, all right, like I said, I'm gonna be 62 here in a few weeks, and I have the dark circle issue, and it's getting better, and I love to use this Prep and Prime, and what I do is I kind of take it down the center of my nose. This, I love this, and this is in the Radiant Rose color. Now I'm just using this case. This is the Laura Mercier powder, my actual powder case folk. So I had to use an empty one that I had. And then what I do is I will just tap a little bit of this powder under my eyes there. And I'm just gonna let it set. It's really, I mean, yes, I have air conditioning, but it gets humid back in this bathroom. This room gets steaming hot. This is the Chanel Ombre eyeshadow. Oh, it's so beautiful. And this is in the color number 808-1501. And it is really beautiful. It's so subtle. It's so soft. And I love it. And it comes with its own applicator brush, and you're just supposed to go back and forth like that. I kind of tap it just into that, close to the bottom lash line. And then I just swing it back and forth on my lash. I think it lifts the eye. Show you again, back and forth. I just kind of, I like to tap it close to the bottom of my, because sometimes I miss that area, and then I just swing it back and forth. And sometimes I just kind of, just to smooth it out. Because you know, when you get to be this age, you kind of have those extra crinkles. I think it's gorgeous. And I just think it's super, super pretty. And gonna apply my mascara. And I, like I said, I'm using this Lancome. And the application of mascara onto lashes that are nourished is the best way I can describe it. Using this Lash Boost from Rodin & Fields, I never ever expected that I would ever have pretty natural looking lashes. And if I really want to zhuzh it up, I'll do extra layers. But just one dip out of the wand, and I'm gonna go ahead and look in my mirror here just so. Get the mascara on them. And since they're longer and they feel thicker, you know, I just have to make sure that I'm utilizing all those pretty lashes. And so there's the application of the top. And I just like to, after brushing them out with a spoolie, I like to tap them up a little bit. Next, I am going to use my favorite Chanel Pink Explosion. Love this blush. And it's soft, it's pretty, and I use this all year round. I have this little sample, and it's from Too Faced, and it's the Chocolate Soleil. I'm just going to do a little contour line, pick it up with another little angled e.l.f. brush. And why I use this is because it is skinny, and I am going to contour right here on my nose and meet it at this line up here and here. It just kind of contours it a little, and then I take this skinny brush and I just like to emphasize this area here just a little bit, not much because I don't want to do a whole lot. I take my IT Cosmetic powder brush and I do go back into my mineral peptide powder, pick up the powder, and soften this area here. This adds a little bit of powder, soften this part up here where I drew that little line. I will also take my Prep and Prime from MAC and spray one or two little sprays, just kind of let it dampen, and just I want to soften that up a little bit. And I'm using this Becca angled brush. This is my all-time favorite Bobbi Brown highlighting powder, and this is in Pink Glow. Ooh, what can I say? I'm a pink kind of person. I swirl it around. I go right here on the upper portion of my cheekbone, and I just put a little bit of that shimmer there, a little bit above my eyebrow to meet there, the center of my nose, Cupid's bow in my chin. And I go back with my powder brush that still has the MAC spray on it. Last thing are just my lips. Just for purposes of this video, I'll line my lips with, and this is Revlon Color Stay, a good lip liner. Lastly, and I cheated because I already put some on, I went ahead after I lined my lips and went in and got my YSL. This is the Rouge Voluptuous Shine, and this is in the number 8. I love this. If you can see, it's a pretty color. Now, the color itself doesn't last that long. But what lasts that I love about this YSL is that the moisture does stay on your lips. And it's all about hydrating, especially in the summer, especially if you live in the South. But your lips and your skin can become dry and parched no matter where you live. So, yes, I am older. Yes, I do use powder. Sure, I have wrinkles and crinkles. But you know, it's all about getting to the point where you know your skin. I am at the point finally in my life, being an ex-product junkie, still love my products, don't get me wrong, but I am finally at the point in my life where I'm not trying to cover up. I am trying to, I think, just create and create a look for me that I'm comfortable with and that I love. Give this video a thumbs up if you like it. And until next time, take time to have a sip of tea or a good cup sip of coffee. Be kind, be humble, and, you know, age gracefully.